Royal Navy, U.S. warship joining HMS Queen Elizabeth to defend North Atlantic amid Russia tensions. It follows reports two Royal Navy ships would leave the carrier strike group and head to the Black Sea. A U.S. warship is joining the Royal Navy's HMS Queen Elizabeth carrier strike group to ensure truly effective deterrence and defense in the North Atlantic amid escalating tensions with Russia. It comes as the U.S. ambassador in Moscow heads back to America for consultations about the current state of bilateral relations between the United States and Russia. The U.S. Navy press office said Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyer USS The Sullivans, DDG-68, had departed from Mayport yesterday in support of British carrier Task Group 21. The warship previously linked up with the UK's flagship in October 2020. The latest link-up comes after reports that a Royal Navy Type 45 destroyer and Type 23 frigate will leave the HMS Queen Elizabeth carrier strike group and sail for the Black Sea, as tensions continue to rise between Ukrainian and Russian forces. The UK and other G7 nations had previously demanded that Russia ends provocations and de-escalates tensions in Ukraine, and US President Joe Biden expelled 10 Russian diplomats and announced a raft of new sanctions in retaliation for alleged hacking and election interference. Russia then announced it was closing a strait in the Black Sea to foreign warships, including the Royal Navy, for the next 6 months. It had previously warned America, as two U.S. destroyers headed towards the area, to stay away from the region for their own good, reported the Mirror. And Reuters reported that the United States had cancelled the deployment of the two warships to the Black Sea, according to Turkish diplomatic sources. The Times then reported that one Type 45 destroyer armed with anti-aircraft missiles and an anti-submarine Type 23 frigate will peel off from the Royal Navy's carrier task group in the Mediterranean and head through the Bosphorus into the Black Sea, according to senior naval sources. Now the US says that the inclusion of US forces in the UK's carrier strike group will improve expeditionary capabilities and interoperability between NATO allies, demonstrating the United States' commitment to the NATO alliance. The Royal Navy's Commodore Tom Guy, Deputy Director of Combined Joint Operations from the Sea Center of Excellence, said, "To ensure truly effective deterrence and defense in the North Atlantic, we need to make sure that the navies of NATO can work as one team, and that means interoperability is vital. This NATO vignette has been a great step forward in pursuing allied interoperability. CJOSCO looks forward to continuing to develop this for future deploying strike groups." U.S. Navy Commander David Burkitt, commanding officer of the Sullivans, said, "It is an honor to sail in this elite multinational strike group on the front line, demonstrating a fully integrated force that showcases the special relationship that our countries have. USS The Sullivans' namesakes would be extremely proud of us as we boldly show that we stick together." Meanwhile, U.S. Ambassador to Russia John Sullivan said in a statement that he is returning to the United States this week to discuss U.S.-Russian ties with members of President Joe Biden's administration. He emphasized that he would come back to Moscow within weeks. "I believe it is important for me to speak directly with my new colleagues in the Biden administration in Washington about the current state of bilateral relations between the United States and Russia," Mr. Sullivan said in a statement issued by the embassy. "Also, I have not seen my family in well over a year, and that is another important reason for me to return home for a visit." Mr. Sullivan's departure comes after Russia on Friday stopped short of asking him to leave the country, but said it suggested that he follows the example of the Russian ambassador to Washington, who was recalled for consultations last month after Mr. Biden's description of President Vladimir Putin as a killer. Russia has set no time frame for Anatoly Antonov's return to Washington. On Thursday, the Biden administration announced sanctions on Russia for interfering in the 2020 U.S. presidential election and involvement in the SolarWind hack of federal agencies, activities Moscow has denied. The U.S. ordered 10 Russian diplomats expelled, targeted dozens of companies and people and imposed new curbs on Russia's ability to borrow money. Russia denounced the U.S. move as absolutely unfriendly and unprovoked and retaliated by ordering 10 U.S. diplomats to leave, blacklisting 8 current and former U.S. officials and tightening requirements for the U.S. embassy operations. While ordering the sanctions, Mr. Biden also called for de-escalating tensions and held the door open for cooperation with Russia in certain areas. Russia said it was studying the offer. "I will return to Moscow in the coming weeks before any meeting between Presidents Biden and Putin," Mr. Sullivan said in Tuesday's statement.